Thank you very much for the introduction. I hope that you see my presentation now.
Yeah, we see.
Good. So I was asked to present some basic principles of Natura 2000 network and also the Czech example, how we approached this task during the accession, the accession process, because at that time I was responsible for that in the Czech Republic.
Dakle, sad ću vam objasniti principe na kojima funkcionira Natura 2000 i kako je to zapravo primijenjeno u Češkoj Republici u ovom procesu pristupa tome.
Just to introduce myself a little bit more, I worked almost in all countries in West Balkan, except for Bosnia and Herzegovina. Last project that I implemented there was in Montenegro, and I will show you some examples at the end of the presentation.
Dakle, samo da se još malo predstavim, ja sam radio u većini zemalja Zapadnog Balkana, osim u Bosni i Hercegovini, a zadnji projekat koji sam radio je bio onaj u Crnoj Gori i na kraju prezentacije ću se, nadam se, zapravo biti u prilici da vam dam nekoliko primjera.
So let's start with the introduction of Natura 2000 network.
Dakle, hajde sada da krenemo sa uvodom vezano za Natura 2000 područja.
In fact, globally, this is the Natura 2000 is globally the largest area network established under one legislation in all 28 or 27 EU member states.
Dakle, u suštini Natura 2000 je najveća mreža zaštićenih područja koja je uspostavljena u skladu sa istim zakonima, odnosno tehničkim kriterijima u 28 zemalja članica Evropske unije.
What is important, especially in your countries, is that Natura 2000 is not Emerald Network, because the predecessor of Natura 2000 was Emerald under the Bern Convention, and in some countries this is still implemented, but this is not the same.
Dakle, ono što je važno napomenuti je da se ne radi o istoj mreži, takozvanoj Emerald mreži, koja je, dakle, ranije postojala u nekim zemljama, dakle, to nije isto.
There are two categories of protected areas of which Natura 2000 is composed.
Dakle, radi se dvije, Natura 2000 se sastoji od dvije komponente. Yes?
I will explain more the difference at the next slide, but here, just to clarify, special protection areas are classified under the Birds Directive that was established in 1979 for birds.
Dakle, radi se o dvije komponente, to su područja od posebne zaštite koja su klasifikana u skladu sa direktivom o pticama iz 1979.
And newly with the Directive on Habitats, we have so-called special areas of conservation that are focused on species and habitats.
Dakle, a u novije vrijeme postoje posebna područja za konzervaciju koja su utvrđena u skladu sa direktivom o staništima i vrstama i vezana su za vrste.
But the whole process of establishment of Natura 2000 is a little bit more complex. Here we can see it.
Ali cijeli proces za utvrđivanje područja Natura 2000 je malo složeniji, kao što vidite ovdje na ovom grafikonu, to je taj proces.
And here also this is a right place to say something about the whole history.
I ovdje je pravo vrijeme da vam kažem nešto malo o istoriji tog postupka.
So as I showed you in the previous slides, the Birds Directive was approved by the Parliament of the European Union in 1979, so it's much older.
Dakle, kao što sam rekao, direktiva o pticama je potvrđena u parlamentu Europskom 1979. Dakle, ona je znatno starija.
And the process or the obligation for states was just to establish special protection areas for birds and to report where they are, their borders, to the European Union.
I u skladu sa tom direktivom, obaveze zemalja su bile samo da uspostave ova područja od posebne zaštite vezano za ptice, te da Evropskoj uniji dojave granice i lokacije istih.
And automatically those that were reported to the European Union without any scrutiny, without any quality check, were part of Natura 2000 network.
I automatski ono što se dešavalo bez ikakvog nadzora, bez ikakve provjere kvaliteta i svega ostalog, ta mjesta, ti lokaliteti su proglašavani područjima Natura 2000.
But it didn't work. In fact, it was so unsuccessful that the European Commission decided to prepare and to approve another directive on habitats that was approved in 1992.
Međutim, ona je bila toliko neuspješna i neefikasna da je Evropska komisija pripremila i donijela novu direktivu o staništima 1992.
And in that, the process is much more sophisticated. So at first, the state proposes sites within the so-called national list of proposed sites.
I u skladu sa tom direktivom o staništima, proces je mnogo sofisticiraniji i mnogo složeniji. Prvo, države stvaraju takozvanu državnu ili nacionalnu listu predloženih područja.
Then the European Commission checks the quality of sites and if they are approved, they are listed in as so-called community sites of community interest.
Dakle, onda kada komisija utvrdi i provjeri kvalitetu, da li je sve u redu, onda se stvara takozvana community lista područja od interesa za zajednicu.
Usually what commission says is that they approve all the sites that are proposed, but they also say that there are some other sites that need to be also established, so the network is still insufficient and the state has still an obligation to enlarge it.
Dakle, ono što se obično dešava je da komisija potvrdi takva područja, međutim, istovremeno se često dešava da kažu da treba utvrditi i dodatna, tako da je mreža proširena.
And there is one important point, which is the site of community interest is just proposed and by the European Commission approved site without any management measures, without any management plan.
I'm sorry, I haven't heard you.
Yeah, okay.
Sound is bad.
What is important aspect is that sites of community interest are just sites that are approved by the Commission, but they don't have any management planning document.
Ono što je važno reći da ova područja od interesa za zajednicu se odobravaju od strane komisije, ali ne moraju imati nikakve planove za upravljanje i sve drugo.
So the state has 6 years since the approval of site of community interest to prepare so-called management measures, which means the management plan for each of those sites and to approve it.
Dakle, državi o kojoj se radi se daje vremenski period od 6 godina u kojem vremenu oni od dana odobrenja tih područja od interesa za zajednicu moraju pripremiti planove za upravljanje istima.
And only sites that have this management plan are included into Natura 2000 network and then the name of them is special areas of conservation.
I samo područja koja zapravo imaju utvrđene i izrađene ove planove upravljanja se potvrđuju kao dio Nature 2000-te s tim što se onda zovu posebna područja za konzervaciju.
Still, we have those two processes because it's impossible to change the directives. So, as you can see, for SPAs, for birds areas, this is much easier, and for other areas, this is such a complicated process.
Međutim, istovremeno, budući da imamo na snazi ove direktive, koje se ne mogu tako mijenjati, ili onda imamo postupak koji se tiče, koji je vezan za direktivu o pticama i koji je znatno jednostavniji u odnosu na ovaj dat na lijevoj strani koji se radi u skladu sa direktivom o staništima.
And now let me explain what does it mean a directive in the legal framework of the European Union.
Sad mi dopustite da vam objasnim šta direktiva u zakonodavnom okviru Evropske unije zapravo znači.
Here you can see four different tools for legal documents, or let's say four legal documents. that are part of the EU nature legislation or EU legislation.
Dakle, ovdje vidite četiri različita tipa dokumenata koja su dio evropskog zakonodavstva.
So recommendation, this is something that is not for us, common people, this is just a politically relevant, and this is just a recommendation.
Dakle, preporuka je nešto što se ne odnosi na obične ljude, ona ima političku važnost I težinu, ali ipak je samo preporuka.
Then you have decision and regulation, and those are entirely binding immediately for the European Union states.
Onda imamo formu dokumenta koja se zove odluka I ona je direktno obvezujuća za one na koje se odnosi, odnosno zemlje članice.
So it means that you have to, as a state, literally follow the text of those decisions and regulations.
Što zapravo znači da efekat na zemlje članice je da vi pratite, kako kažu, svako slovo, sve što je napisano u tim odlukama I regulativama.
But the directive is a different kind of tool.
Međutim, direktiva kao takva je sasvim drugi mehanizam.
Because results that are there, written and explained, are mandatory, but ways to transpose it at your country level are quite free or open.
Dakle, rezultati direktive su obavezni. Dakle, morate postići obavezne rezultate, međutim, put, metode I oblici za ovu pravnu transpoziciju u zemlje članice Evropske unije su vam otvoreni. Dakle, možete to učiniti kako želite.
So you have quite large space as a country for your specific approach, taking into account your local conditions.
Dakle, što to zapravo znači za zemlju, za državu? Dakle, da imate veliki prostor da primijenite za određenu državu vrlo specifične pristupe u tom smislu.
And here is the example. So on the map you can see Germany with violet sides and Czech Republic with green sides.
Dakle, primjer toga je na ovoj mapi ovdje, dakle, imamo upoređenje između Češke Republike I Njemačke.
I'm sorry, Michal, the connection is not the best. Maybe it's better if you switch off your camera.
I will. Just give me a minute.
Thank you.
Good. Is it better? Can you hear me better?
Yes.
Good. So here you can see the example of two European Union countries and quite different approach how to establish Natura 2000 network.
Dakle, ovdje vidite dvije zemlje članice EU-a koje su imale potpuno sasvim različit pristup uspostavi područja Natura 2000.
While German colleagues, they followed alluvial forests and rivers, we were more about either small sites for one or two target species or habitats or larger sites.
Dok su njemačke kolege su bile koncentrirane na ove aluvijalna staništa, dakle mi smo se I šume, mi smo se koncentrisali u Češkoj Republici rađe na manja staništa, manja područja.
Both approaches are approved by the European Commission as well as sites that were proposed.
Dakle, oba ova pristupa, kao I predložena područja, su bila odobrena od strane Evropske komisije.
Yeah. So now let's talk a little bit about technical principles of Natura 2000.
Sada ćemo malo razgovarati o tehničkim principima Nature 2000-te.
I would like to mention what is the difference between nationally designated area and Natura 2000.
Htio bih da kažem malo o razlici između nacionalnih razni utvrđenih područja zaštite I Nature 2000.
Well, yeah, as we talked about, there are two categories of Natura 2000 sites, so SPAs are for birds.
Dakle, govorimo o dvije kategorije Natura 2000 područja, SPA se odnosi na ptice.
while SACs are those special areas of conservation, they are designated for habitat types or animal species or plant species.
Dok se ova područja, posebna područja za konzervaciju odnoš, u skladu sa direktivom o staništima odnose na dakle, staništa vezano za određene životinske i biljne vrste.
All those species and habitats are listed in annexes of the directives, so it's quite clear for which of them you have to designate your national Natura 2000 network.
I dakle sve to je vrlo jasno navedeno u direktivi o staništima, tako da na nacionalnom nivou vrlo je jasno šta trebate uraditi za određenu vrstu.
Of course, mainly those are so-called umbrella species, so via their protection or conservation you also protect other phenomena.
Naravno, većina tih dakle, vrsta se radi se o krovnim, dakle, koje se odnose i na neke, koje pokrivaju neke druge vrste.
But the system as a whole, as you can see, is very systematic and there is nothing in between those annexes of directives, just species and just habitats.
I međutim sistem je vrlo jasan, znači nema ništa viška tu, on je namijenjen vrstama. It was just for, sorry, species and...
Just species and habitats, nothing okay. In between.
Okay, dakle radi se samo o vrstama i staništima, nema ništa između.
While when we are talking about nationally designated areas, you can designate them for any kind of natural or semi-natural or even artificial phenomena in your landscape, in your country, as you wish.
Kad se govori o nacionalno utvrđenim zaštićenim područjima, ona mogu biti namijenjena bilo kojim vrstama, prirodnim, poluprirodnim, čak i umjetno stvorenim. Dakle, to je do vas.
It could be a river ecosystem, it could be a mining area, it can be a high meadow, as you wish.
Dakle, može to biti može to biti neko područje gdje je vršeno rudarenje, visoke livade, livade na uzvisinama, kako želi.
So and this is I think one of the biggest differences. You are quite free how you designate Natura 2000 network following or how you read the directives in your conditions. Mm-hmm. But the phenomena, the target species and habitat types, they are defined since the beginning of the process, and you have only very small space to change this.
Dakle, ovo je ono što treba napomenuti. Dakle, vi možete utvrditi, utvrđivati Natura 2000, dakle, kako želite. Međutim, ono što je vrlo definirano je na samom početku su te vrste koje se, koje, i tu imate vrlo malo slobode.
Then, of course, because every country already has a kind of nationally protected areas network, then you should think if Natura 2000 is added as new two categories to the system or if it is somehow included in existing categories.
Dakle, ono, naravno, svaka država, svaka zemlja ima svoje nacionalne kategorizaciju zaštićenih područja i pri utvrđivanju Nature 2000 morate razmišljati da li ona prilikom utvrđivanja dodaje vašim kategorijama ili je već uključena u postojeće.
Here you can see both approaches on the right side. This is just an example. If you add two categories because of the new legislation and your accession to the European Union, on the left side you can see that just it is somehow included in existing areas. But I have to say that this approach on the left has some disadvantages. And I will talk about it a bit later.
Dakle, s lijeve strane imate situaciju u kojoj je ta su područja Natura 2000 te na neki način već inkorporirana, već postoji u vašoj postojećoj kategorizaciji, dok s desne strane imate dodavanje određenih kategorija zaštite, a ja ću govoriti o stranama koje ova, ovaj pristup s lijeve strane ima.
And of course, when you establish Natura 2000 in your country, you will not avoid some overlaps with existing nationally designated areas.
Naravno, pri utvrđivanju i određivanju područja Natura 2000 ne možete izbjeći određena preklapanja sa onima koji su utvrđeni kao područje od zaštite ili zaštićena područja na nacionalnom.
I would like to warn you to merge those sites or to unify their borders for any price, because the original reason for establishment of national designated sites could be different than for Natura 2000 network.
I ja, moj savjet je bio da na neki način spojite i unificirate ta područja, jer prvobitni razlog zašto se na nacionalnom nivou možda donijela odluka o zaštićenom području nije isti kao za ovo.
Why? Because those sites often have different conservation objectives, not the same.
A razlog je zato što ta mjesta konzervacije vrlo često imaju različite ciljeve, ne moraju biti to isti ciljevi.
In the picture you can see a little bit more complicated situation as an example from the Czech Republic.
Ovdje na slici možete vidjeti malo kompliciraniju situaciju koja dolazi iz Češke Republike.
In the violet, this is nationally designated area existing for tens of years.
Ljubičasta, baš nije neka ljubičasta, dakle su je nacionalno područje koje je na nacionalnom nivou utvrđeno kao zaštićeno područje i postoji deseta godina.
While those two sites in a light green, those are newly designated Natura 2000 sites.
Ove svjetlo zeleno, to su područja, novo utvrđena područja Natura 2000-te.
For totally different target species than the original site in violet was designated.
Za potpuno različite vrste od onih koje su utvrđene u skladu sa, za područje koje je označeno ljubičastom bojom.
And this is also how I recommend, if you are in the preparatory phase of Natura 2000 establishment in your country, to add those two categories of Natura 2000 as new ones to your national system of categories.
I ovo je ono što ja preporučujem ako ste u pripremnoj fazi za priključenje Natura 2000 mreži, da dodate ta područja kao dodatna područja.
Because if you try to designate Natura 2000 in existing categories, and mainly in already designated areas, you will be very limited.
Jer ukoliko pokušate da, dakle, to radite na temelju ovih nacionalno utvrđenih područja zaštite, onda ćete biti veoma ograničeni.
And those your country, protected areas, are often, they don't cover what is needed, what is requested by Natura 2000. Yeah,
sorry,
I just wanted to say that your nationally designated areas, the network of protected areas in countries,
often
don't cover target species and habitat types that are listed in the annexes of directives.
Znači, i to iz razloga što, dakle, mreža zaštićenih područja u vašoj zemlji ne mora uključivati i vrlo često ne uključuje ciljane vrste i staništa u skladu sa evropskim
direktivama. I will try to simplify. I know that I'm quite complicated about how I say this, so I will try to be simple.
Dakle, pokušat ću da to uprostim, znam da zvuči dosta komplicirano.
There is also a legal difference between national protected areas and Natura 2000.
Dakle, postoji razlika između Natura 2000 područja i nacionalnih područja pod zaštitom.
Your national protected areas are usually established in let's say, a negative way, because there is a list of prohibited or restricted activities for each of them.
Razlika je u tome što su vaše nacionalna zaštićena područja u skladu na nacionalnom nivou su obično rađena na takozvanim negativnim osnovama, što znači da uvijek imate jedan spisak zabranjenih ili ograničenih aktivnosti u
istu. So, Natura 2000 has a different approach. There are just two basic obligations.
Nasuprot tome, Natura 2000 je stvorena i urađena na sasvim drugim, suprotnim, dakle, temeljima. Imate dvije osnovne obaveze.
The first obligation is that you need to keep a status of target features, I mean species and habitats, in a good state or to improve it.
Prva obaveza je da održavate status, dakle stanje ciljanih karakteristika, znači vrsta i staništa od određenog područja.
And the second is that you have to assess is that could somehow affect Natura 2000 sites.
I drugi uslov je, druga obaveza je da imate odgovarajuće planove planove i projekte i ciljeve procjene na osnovu kojih će zapravo imati utjecaj na
and
ta
of course područja. You can permit only those activities that don't have any negative effect.
I naravno vi u skladu s tim možete omogućiti, odnosno dozvoliti samo one aktivnosti koje nemaju negativan utjecaj.
And one more very important information is that once you establish your Natura 2000 network, so the Commission, the European Commission approves your sites, you are not allowed to change their borders without agreement of the European Commission.
Još jedan od dakle izazova je da jednom kad uspostavite mrežu Natura 2000 područja, dakle vi ne možete bez dozvole Evropske komisije da mijenjate granice istoga.
And this is very important to think twice before you designate those sites, otherwise you can have a problem later if they are too large or too narrow.
I ovo je još nešto što morate imati na umu, dakle, prilikom utvrđivanja granica, dakle, morate znati da ukoliko proglasite preveliko područje ili premalo, preusko područje, da to ne možete baš tako lako mijenjati.
So now, let me tell you something a little bit about the Czech approach, because I was asked for that specifically.
Sad mi dopustite da kažem koju riječ vezano za češki pristup ovome, budući da je to bio moj konkretan zadatak da vam predočim.
So we started preparatory phase in 1999.
Mm-hmm. Dakle, počeli smo sa pripremnom fazom 1999.
And the problem for us was that those, let's say, 5 years was just insufficient time for a really proper preparation.
Problem u našem slučaju je bio što tih 5 godina koji smo imali zapravo je bio nedovoljan za pravilnu i temeljnu pripremu.
I'm always laughing when I hear in some countries, including those from your region, if some politician says, in 1 or 2 years we will fully establish Natura 2000. It's impossible.
I ja se uvijek nasmijem kad neki političari iz vašeg regiona kažu da će im trebati 1 do 2 godine da implementiraju, odnosno provedu Naturu 2000, to je naprosto nemoguće.
So, there are two possible ways. Of course, you can try to propose your national network of protected areas only, which is very fast.
Dakle, postoje dva moguća pristupa. Jedan je da pokušate da predložite svoju nacionalnu mrežu zaštićenih područja, što je zapravo...
Or the second is to take advantage of the process and to conduct a real inventory of biodiversity in your country.
A drugi pristup je zapravo drugi pristup se tiče toga da provedete zaista stvarni popis biodiverziteta.
And we chosen the second option.
Mi smo odabrali drugu opciju.
We persuaded our politicians that without a real inventory, without a real data from the field, we are not able to designate Natura 2000 network.
Mi smo ubijedili naše političare da bez pravog popisa, bez toga nećemo biti u stanju da proglasimo područja Natura 2000.
And without designated Natura, you cannot access the European Union.
A bez utvrđenih područja 2000, Natura 2000, ne možete pristupiti Evropskoj uniji.
Of course, we had an advantage because that time everybody, including politicians, had a really significant willingness to join the EU. Everybody wanted it.
Međutim, mi smo imali jednu značajnu prednost, obzirom da u vrijeme o kojem govorimo, svi, uključujući i političare, su bili voljni i željni da mi pristupimo Evropskoj uniji.
The first thing that we had to do was to interpret or translate the interpretation manual for habitat types from the European level to the national level.
Prva stvar koju smo morali uraditi, dakle, to je priručnik za tumačenje, dakle, ovih vrsta sa evropskog nivoa na nacionalni nivo.
Why? Because this interpretation manual at the European level is very, very general.
Zato što je taj priručnik ili zapravo o tumačenju vrlo općenit.
So we prepared our national so-called catalog of biotopes.
Tako da smo mi pripremili naš nacionalni katalog biotopa.
That split or divided each European habitat to much more specific national biotope types.
Koji je zapravo podijelio ili podpodijelio vrstu staništa na kako se naziva na nivou Europe na mnogo konkretnije, detaljnije.
And of course, we also did it because we followed our national needs. We needed this more specific system or categorization of biotopes because we used that a long time before.
I uradili smo to naravno i zato što smo ovaj konkretnu kategorizaciju biotopa mi koristili mnogo prije sve ove priče sa Evropskom unijom.
Then the second step, when we had this interpretation manual, we developed IT tools for data storage and gathering. We had two, species occurrence database and habitat occurrence database.
Dakle, ono što smo, sljedeći korak, drugi korak je nakon što smo imali urađen ovaj priručnik, onda smo izradili i napravili IT alatke, odnosno mehanizme za pohranu podataka i analitičku aplikaciju i to je bila baza podataka o pojavljivanju, dakle, učestalosti vrsta i baza podataka o učestalosti staništa.
Why? Because, of course, we expected that we will gather a lot of data from the whole country, and it's impossible to do it just via Excel sheet or some very basic IT tools. You need to have something more sophisticated.
I zašto smo to uradili? Zato što sa prostim IT alatkama naprosto nismo očekivali da ćemo moći dakle, urediti sve te podatke koje smo očekivali i sa cijelog teritorija naše zemlje.
And finally, of course, we conducted a field inventory both for habitat types and for species.
I konačno, na kraju izvršili smo popis, terenski popis i za vrste i za staništa.
Here, what you can see in the slide, this is just about habitats as the example.
Ovdje na slajdu vidite samo primjer vezan za staništa.
We had, as I said, 5 vegetation seasons during 5 years, and we had 600 mappers that we paid for.
Dakle, pokrili smo 5 vegetacijskih sezona, doba i 600 ljudi je radilo izradu ovih mapa, mapiranje.
We spent approximately 4 million of euros.
Potrošili smo otprilike 4 miliona eura u ove svrhe.
Of course, what was very important that it was coordinated at the national level by the Czech Nature Conservation Agency.
Naravno, vrlo je važno da je koordinacija vršena sa vrha od strane Češke agencije za konzervaciju, odnosno očuvanje prirode.
So all experts, including institutions from academic sphere, were contracted by this Czech Nature Conservation Agency.
Dakle, svi eksperti, uključujući one sa akademskog nivoa koji su se bavili ovim pitanjima, su pod ugovorom, dakle, dobili ugovore za ovaj posao sa Češkom agencijom za zaštitu prirode.
Because although Natura 2000 requires some scientific background, this is finally a pure nature conservation. This is not an academic or, let's say, scientific work.
Iako, dakle, Natura 2000 zahtjeva nekakav naučni pristup, radi se o čistom očuvanju, čistoj konzervaciji, dakle, to nije naučni rad, to je očuvanje prirode.
What is the result of those five-year-long work? It is visible here. We mapped all natural and semi-natural biotopes in the Czech Republic in a scale 1 to 10,000.
Dakle, rezultat ovog petogodišnjeg rada je bilo da smo zabilježili sva prirodna i poluprirodna biotope u Češkoj i to je na mapi 1:10 razmjera, 1:10,000.
If you go into the detail, you can have a lot of information about each segment and you can see it also in a very, very, very small scale.
Dakle, ukoliko želite da idete u detalje, možete sve to vidjeti, možete to vidjeti u maloj razmjeri ako vam je potrebno.
And here you can see how we use that for the delineation or demarcation of Natura 2000 sites.
Ovdje vidite kako smo koristili, dakle, razgraničenje, ocrtavanje za ovaj Natura 2000 područja.
So this is just an example. Those plots in orange, those are habitat types of European interest, so listed in the directives annex.
Which color, sorry?
Orange.
Dakle, primjer, dakle, ovo označeno narandžastom bojom su oni od značaja za evropski nivo.
So we established sites that were covered or that where the area was preliminary or mainly composed of those areas or those habitats or species habitats that were of the European interest.
Dakle, primarno smo uspostavili dakle staništa za one vrste koje su od važnosti na evropskom nivou.
And we had finally in 2004, which was the accession date, the biogeographical seminar, which is the communication with the European Commission.
Konačno 2004. kada smo pristupili EU, održali smo takozvani biogeografski seminar koji je organizirala Evropska komisija.
We had the smallest average of size of Natura 2000 sites because we had very precise data and thus also delineation.
Imali smo najmanju prosječnu veličinu ovih područja budući da smo imali ta jasna, tačna razgraničenja.
Of course, the discussion was based on real data, not just presumptions by experts.
Naravno, razgovaralo se i diskutiralo o stvarnim podacima, a ne samo o pretpostavkama.
But that time the decision of the European Commission was okay, your proposal is very quality one, but still insufficient.
Međutim, u to vrijeme zaključak je bio da, da, vaš prijedlog je dobar, ali i dalje je to nedovoljno.
It just shows that I really appreciate that the European Commission spends a lot of time to ask another independent experts and to really assess your network in a quality way, but it's very tough process. This is not just easy going process.
Dakle, ono što treba imati na umu, da, dakle, Evropska unija će angažirati nezavisne stručnjake da urade tu procjenu i procjenu kvaliteta. Međutim, radi se o tome da je to proces.
And finally, let me share with you, Let me share it with you just lessons that we learned in the Czech Republic.
I na kraju podijelit ću sa vama one lekcije ili ono što smo naučili iz iskustva Češke Republike.
If you want to carry out the task, I mean the Natura 2000 establishment properly, inventory in the field is necessary.
Dakle, ako želite da odradite zadatak vezan za Natura 2000 kako treba, onda terenski popis je neophodan. Dakle, to je ono nešto što morate, ili terensko istraživanje morate uraditi.
IT tool is essential because you are gathering a lot of data and you need to analyze them in a unified way.
Dakle, potrebni su vam IT mehanizmi, alatke i oni su od suštinske važnosti jer trebate skupiti i analizirati podatke.
But I just want to warn you, the IT tool is not a goal, this is just a tool. Don't play too much with this, it just serves the data.
Dakle, ali moram vas upozoriti, IT alatke su samo sredstvo, a ne sami cilj. Dakle, nemojte se puno zabaviti ili poigravati s tim.
I saw in few countries in your region that they started to develop a kind of sophisticated IT tool and finally they spent much more capacities on it just than done on the field work.
Dakle, ono što sam vidio u par zemalja vašeg regiona je da su oni potrošili previše vremena i svega ostalog napora na izradi tih sofisticiranih IT alatki, da im nije, a premalo vremena na terenu.
And the final lesson is that all activities that are leading to fulfill this obligation should be, let's say, applicable at the national level. I will try to explain it more.
Dakle, i konačno morate voditi računa da sve aktivnosti koje su zapravo usmjerene ka ispunjenju obaveza prema EU bi trebale da budu primjenjive na vašem nacionalnom, odnosno državnom nivou i to ću malo dalje objasniti.
What I mean is that everything that you do about Natura 2000 establishment must be also beneficial for your national nature legislation, national nature conservation.
Ono što želim reći da sve što uradite vezano za Naturu 2000 mora biti od koristi i vezano za očuvanje prirode na nacionalnom nivou.
It's impossible to say this is just a legal obligation, so let's implement it because we have to. But without any added value for yourself.
Dakle, nemoguće reći, dakle, ovo je Natura 2000 i mi ćemo to ispuniti zato što moramo. Dakle, nemoguće i nemoguće to uraditi bez da ne stvarate dodanu vrijednost za svoju zemlju.
This is, you know, this Natura 2000 is in many cases a very good opportunity to improve the whole nature conservation system, to professionalize it.
Dakle, Natura 2000 je veoma dobra prilika da se poboljša cijeli sistem zaštite prirode, da se na neki način to profesionalizuje.
So my recommendation is to take advantage of it.
Tako da vam ja preporučujem da to iskoristite.
Here, as I mentioned at the beginning, this is an example of habitat mapping from Montenegro.
Ovo je onaj primjer koji sam vam obećao na početku. To je dakle mapiranje staništa iz koje je rađeno u Crnoj Gori.
As you can see, the methodology is based on the Czech approach.
Kao što vidite, metodologija je bila zasnovana na češkom pristupu.
The collective or the group of professionals or experts that carried out the task in the field was international.
Dakle, grupa ljudi, profesionalaca, eksperata koja je to odradila na terenu je radilo se o međunarodnim.
Not only experts from Montenegro itself, but also from Serbia and Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Sorry, international or national?
International. So the group of experts that mapped habitats in the field were international. It was people from Montenegro, Serbia, and also from Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Okay. Dakle, grupa ljudi koja je vršila ovo, dakle, mapiranje na terenu je bila međunarodna. Dakle, to su bili ljudi ne samo iz Crne Gore, nego iz Bosne i Hercegovine i tako dalje, Srbije.
And it was very good cooperation. I really appreciated it that time. And I think the result is very quality one. So you can also check the project results, Natura 2000 in Montenegro, completed in 2019. Mm-hmm. And to inspire yourself in your countries.
I moram reći da su rezultati bili jako dobri, da je 2019. Ovaj posao već u Crnoj Gori vezano za Naturu 2000. Završen. Nadam se da ćete to shvatiti kao inspirativnu stvar za vaše zemlje.
So that's all from my side. Thank you very much for your attention.
Dakle, to je sve što sam ja imao reći. Hvala vam na pažnji.
And I'm ready for your questions if you have any now, or you can send me an email.
Dakle, spreman sam za vaša pitanja. Ako ne, možete ih dostaviti e-mailom.